some relationship goals, especially when it has to do with a crowd that's about 30 to 40% of our Sunday morning adult audience, which is single. This is an important thing, and I just want to give you an idea from the beginning. Guys, gals, some of you are probably going to get a little ticked off today, and you're going to go, that's just stupid. I mean, that is so old-fashioned, that's so dumb, you sound like my dad. And well, I just want to say from the beginning, don't turn off, would you? Don't just shut your head down, don't throw your walls up. I want to talk about some stuff and just ponder, just kind of listen, think about it, and maybe you'll find a nugget in there that you can grab hold of. Now, here's the thing. If you don't agree with me in the end, I'm glad you're here, and I want you here next week. If you still don't agree with me next week, I still want you here. And so don't think, oh, I just dislike what the pastor says. That's it. I'm not coming back. You'll never find a church anywhere if that's your value system. I want to just challenge you as we go into it, because God's Word has actually a lot to say about relationships. There are so many just golden nuggets that I can pull from here and then put into my life. And here's the thing. If you do, you start to find out, wow, maybe God's way has something in it. In fact, wouldn't you think that if you want God's blessing, maybe you ought to consider God's way? See, that's not our way. That's not my way. I know when I started the whole dating scene and relationships, I just thought about me, and just like you, there were a lot of things that my parents told me that I'm like, whatever, Dad. And the problem is you kind of reap what you sow then, and it's painful, and there can be some difficult things. And this is not a sermon that's about looking down my nose on anything. It's hopefully giving you some tools so that you can have successful relationships. And also, here's the thing, pain is easier prevented than healed. Regret is easier prevented than healed. Scars are easier prevented than healed. Once that pain, once that hurt, once that scar, once that regret enters in, it's just managing the hurt and the pain. You really can't totally heal it outside of God's Holy Spirit. And that's what I want to kind of discuss today, because you know, there are 20-somethings in here who jump from relationship after relationship after relationship, and they're just trying to look for something. They're trying to find that right one, and they're trying to find just some fun and some joy in life. There's the 30-something who's still hearing from mom going, when are you going to get married? When are you going to get married? I know, mom, back off. And there's the 40-something who's now stepping back into this whole scene of dating going, I never planned on this after a painful divorce. And there's the 60-something who's now the widower, and it's been decades since they even considered a date, let alone courting, or what does this look like, and there's guilt that they deal with. And so God's Word does have something to say about that, and I want to take some principles that, here's the key, they apply to every relationship. So if you're married, or if you're not planning on getting married, if you're single, or you're just in a work environment, guess what? There is wisdom here that you can apply to your life, regardless of whether you're dating or not. I'm just going to focus on this area of dating. And so right off, we're going to look in Ephesians chapter 5, and the first several verses, there's just a lot of wisdom here. We start with verse 1. Imitate God, therefore, in everything you do. It's a good place to start. You know, being Christ-like, just following him. He says, because we are his dear children. He goes on saying in verse 2, live a life filled with love. Following the example of Christ, which, side note, his love is sacrificial. Our love is totally selfish, if not careful. Society says, get something, grab something, go for it. You deserve. Christ says, no, you lay your life down as I did, totally different. Go back to the second part of verse 2. He loved us and he offered himself up as a sacrifice for us. It's a pleasing aroma to God. Whew. Goal number one. Grab right out of there is just be Christ-like. Hey, that is the...